team.
Yes.
Same moment inside the room where Arvind Kejriwal and the entire party were celebrating. Much more organized celebration this time. It was craziness at that point of time, Rajdeep. Let's quickly just take a look.
That's right. And even while you go into the election vault, we are seeing these images of Amit Shah being fed laddus. Clearly, the Aam Aadmi Party saw this as a battle between Shah and Kejriwal. And as one of the Aam Aadmi Party workers told me, we have now kept today Shah in Bagh. It's not Shaheen Bagh, but Shah is in the Bagh, in the garden. But go ahead.
And you did ask him the question, is the election between Arvind Kejriwal and Amit Shah? He said very clearly they need to first come up with a candidate. That has been one calling card. I'm going down to the vault right now, the election vault of India today, to give you a sense of the vote share. How has the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP has been performing as far as the vote share is concerned? 54% is playing 40% and to the 4% of the Congress party. So the same vote share that the Aam Aadmi Party got in 2015 elections, just about the same vote share in the 2020 election, BJP has a significant increase. And the Congress the last time had 10% vote share, 6 less than. It seems to have gone down to the BJP. Pradeep Gupta, more or less just the same kind of vote share that you had predicted in the India Today Access My India poll as well. 2% less for the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP taking almost the entire chunk from the Congress.
Yes, in fact, if you see other way round, it's not that the Congress vote has entirely shifted to the BJP. In fact, there are others also.
So basically parties also, like the BSP, Independents, yes, all the smaller all parties of Delhi, yes, Akalis, yes, all have got squeezed in this election.
Yes.
And their vote has either gone largely to the BJP.
Can you imagine Congress getting 4%?
It is astonishing. You're absolutely right. There are constituencies where the Congress is getting 150 and 200
votes. Yeah,
where
is the scope for any other party, independent, or BSP or so and so on?
See, Rajdeep, I have one question.
Yes.
If the BJP had not polarized after January 22nd,
yes,
would the outcome of this election been the bottom end of what Pradeep had predicted? 2 for the BJP.
That's true.
You think that the BJP saved itself from a complete embarrassment? Yes. That 2 became 13 because 13 as of now because of the polarization.
I'm asking everybody a question. Rahul, what is the thing?
Rajdeep, yes, my view is that the gains that BJP may have made electorally, the minuscule gains, they have negated by the damage they have done by this rhetoric. And I also want our producers to put out the statistics of how many seats did Mr. Yogi campaign in and how many have they, how have the BJP...
This is
by far the most vitriolic and most communal election I have at least witnessed in Delhi in the 37 years that I've been living.
But how is it polarizing? Because if you look at the seats, most of them are coming from east, are from these unauthorized colony area. That's where are they? It's not really
except,
the effect of impact of polarizing.
Yogi Adityanath,
the attempt was made. The attempt has not worked. Now, we can argue for a variety of reasons why the attempt has not worked. Let's take that to Gitanjali Sharma of the